Security class. Today I will show you how to set different safety parameters and alarms on the ECDIS. I have here prepared two sets of safety parameters. I will enter the set A parameters on the ECDIS. So my first requirement is set the following safety parameters. 1.1 is the contour equivalent to 32 meters. 1.2 safety contour 11 meters, 1.3 shallow contour 8 meters, 1.4 safety depth 11 meters, and 1.5 safety height 20 meters. Now let's proceed to the ECDIS screen. So on the ECDIS screen, using the cursor, just click right, then a menu sets of menu will open. So I select the chart setting menu. Click left, then a dialog box CMAP setting will appear. There are three pages that you can select. Now you can see the presentation page composed of different layers, presentations, and display you want to put on the ECDIS. Then we go to the next page, which is the safety page. So on the safety page, you can enter the different values in the text boxes. So to start again, the deep contour is 32 meters. That's why you type on the keyboard 32 meters. Then the safety contour 11 meters. Then the shallow contour is 8 meters. Safety depth equivalent to 11 meters. Then lastly, the safety height, which is 20 meters. So you can directly input this on the keyboard, or you can also use the arrow up, arrow down in entering the different values. After entering all the values, if this is unchecked, just put a check on the use two colors for waters. Then after checking, you can now click the apply button. So the parameters that had been entered is already applied on the ECDIS screen. Then click OK. Okay, that is the first parameter, setting the following safety parameters. Next, number two, set anti-grounding alarms. So the parameters are 2.1 guard zone angle, which is 25 degree. 2.2 look ahead in minutes. The requirement is 6 minutes. And display and highlight dangers always. Then 2.4 safety zone switch on. Okay, again, we go back to the ECDIS screen. To enter those parameters, move the cursor on the toolbar panel on the upper left. Then on the shift properties toolbar panel, just click left. Again, a dialog box will appear, the shift properties. There are again several pages. Just select the alarm page. Then enter, you can now enter the angle. The required angle again is 25 meters. That's why you can use the arrow down to set the angle. So we already entered the 25 degree. The look ahead in minutes, the requirement is 6 minutes. So you can use arrow down to reduce the previous value, change it to 6 minutes. Then display and highlight dangers, so I select always. Then activate the XTD route. So I will already enter the anti-grounding alarms. Before we close this window, don't forget to check the safety zone. So after checking the safety zone, then you can now close this SIPS property window. Okay, next, we have already entered all from one requirement. Next requirement, third and lastly, set the route alarm values. So we have the last waypoint arrival time. The required value is 5 minutes. the early course change indication 2 minutes and the course change alarm 30 seconds. Say again, on the exit screen, drag your cursor on the option toolbar panel. So this is the option toolbar panel, click left, then option dialog box will open, select the root page, then on the root alarm box, now enter the last weapon arrival time requirement, which is 5 minutes. You can highlight then enter directly on your keyboard 5, or again you can use arrow down, arrow right, arrow up. Then again, next requirement is early course change, which is 2 minutes. Enter the 2 minutes using keyboard. Then lastly, the course change alarm, the requirement is 30 seconds. Highlight the value, then type 30. Then after typing, after entering the 3 values, then click apply. Then click OK. So we already entered all the required safety parameters and alarms on the ECDIS. Okay, that is our exercise number 5. Again, setting safety parameters and alarms on ECDIS. Thank you for watching and listening.